Would you like me to do a little intro, or should we just get straight into it?
Sure, do an intro. You're better at it than me.
Okay. Hello, everybody. I'm RuudDevil, and welcome to Edain 4.3. I am joined by Rohan's favorite son. It's Elite KryPtik. Say hello.
Hello, everybody. Happy to finally be on RuudDevil's channel. I've been bugging him like a crazy person for the past few months.
He's the one who kicked my ass ages ago, is Rohan. There'll be a link to his channel in the description, so if you want to watch someone who actually does know how to play this game, I would highly recommend watching his videos.
And, I want to note as well that I sucked back when I kicked your ass as Rohan.
That doesn't bode well for me. But anyway, today we're going to be checking out the new faction against, actually, a faction that was reworked as well. It's going to be Angmar v. Dwarves. 1K start. Are you all ready to go?
I'm good to go.
Here we go. I've had from watching your videos of the tournament, I've had a newfound love of hero rushing, just building like four heroic statues and then going crazy.
Yeah, that's an interesting strategy. I'm still not totally 100% whether or not it's actually useful against a player who plays smart, but...
Yeah. Because if you lose one of those heroes, then it is really costly to replace.
Yes.
Unless you've used, like in Gondo's case, unless you've used Baragond. But, oh man. Anyway, here we go.
Oh man, I've got the jitters. I've got the jitters. I can't play.
Okay.
Alright.
Oh, Rabble from Gundabad. Oh god, first quote's come out already. Okay.
Do you think I give a dead dog about your threats, you pointy eared princess?
I think Thranduil probably felt pretty good at that moment in time until he realized that they had Siege, but.
Yeah, that's like the greatest moment in any film.
Yeah, my friend, who's just a diehard elf lover, was like, was anyone else upset when the elves got wrecked? And they're like, no, it's just
talking about Gil Salad or Vector.
How did you know? Holy crap, it was Gil Salad.
I watch all your content, dude. I'm a big fan.
Okay.
Alright.
I don't know, you're probably dead, but you probably remember just how strong the walls used to be.
The what?
How strong the direwolves used to be.
Oh yeah, the unmounted ones for Angmar.
Yeah, they're so beautiful. Okay. So this should be fun, because I don't, you know this, I don't really play to win, I play just to have fun, but
yeah.
Don't take this personally, I want to beat you. I want to beat you hard. I want to beat you so hard.
We'll see, Angmar's pretty overpowered, so you've got a decent chance of doing it, but.
Yeah, as I say to everyone that says things like that, you imply I know what I'm doing.
We'll give it our best shot. We'll see.
You have no idea how much I've learned just from watching you play, or just watching your videos.
Well, I'm glad.
Like, I really didn't know much about Edain. Like, I never realized how useful people like Pippin were and things like that.
Oh yeah, everything's useful if you use it right.
So, if anyone's watching out there and they're thinking, well, I want to get better at Edain, I really don't know what I'm doing, then watch KryPtik. He knows what he's doing.
Well,
I don't know what they're doing, okay. I won't even tell you what just happened. Never mind.
Okay, well, I want to give a couple of very quick tips just that I give to all people who are new to the game. First off, always fill your base as quickly as you can. The longer those plots go unbuilt, the less money you're making.
Right. Okay.
Secondly, scout heroes are very important. Always make them. They help you. They help you with creeping. And then finally, this is something that can't be taught, but you have to learn to multitask. You have to learn to be all over the map at once.
Right.
And use hotkeys. You know, H for home, space for events. Obviously.
H for home, holy shit. I totally knew that. I wasn't just surprised. There is no deception. Okay.
There's all kinds of little ones that can help, so keep that in mind.
So you're playing as the Mighty Dwarves. I had a good go at the Dwarves earlier today. I managed to take out two people in a free-for-all this morning as Dwarves, so I'm feeling good.
Cool, which faction did you try?
Iron Hills. I ram-rided the crap out of them.
Yep. I like Always Iron fun. Hills a lot, too, now.
I'm still... I mean, you might have a different opinion on me than me, but I'm still not completely sure if the Eridlwin, like, triple damage on the flank is actually that useful.
Well, Well, it's all about how good at flanking you are, I guess. If you split your army, like if you have, say, 12 guardians and you split them into three groups of four, it's actually a lot easier than you might think.
Right, okay.
Just like, I don't know how much Total War you played, you produced a few videos for them, but if you hit enemies with cavalry from three different sides at once, you'll do far more damage.
Okay, right.
Hi there.
We've got the first little action of the game. We've got some mighty Iron Hills, it seems. So a lot of defense going on.
Orcs and wolves.
All I've got is some mighty Gundabad orcs. I think they can take you. I'm not scared at all. What are you talking about? We both got a mutual debuff. I think you're just outside my range. And they've hit level 2, so maybe we should just get out of here.
I didn't even use stubbornness because of the debuff being there.
Mm.
Come back here, you filthy orcs!
I'm really glad that Angmar has walls, because that gives me a little bit of a buffer if I have to dig in deep. I don't know if you ever saw my fight with Vector Maximus, but I essentially just frustrated the hell out of him as Gondor and just...
I'm going to make an enemy here, but my god, he played terribly.
Mm. Yeah, he really just let me do whatever I wanted, didn't he?
Yeah. And I thought his faction was supposed to be elves. But he was good for it. Yeah, I'm so sorry, Vector. I'm sorry.
You aren't like that.
I've got him linked on the right side of my channel, too. So.
All right, Angmar, don't let me down. You're
going
faction.
Freaking barrel whites, damn it. I hate
barrel
whites.
Unfortunately, the attack debuff was at that one you already destroyed. Oh, boy. Freaking dwarves! Have you learned nothing of the stubbornness of dwarves? Knowing you, you'll find a way to summon Theoden and chant death and just have the greatest time.
Well, I could always say his speech when I'm about to win if you want me to. Tighten up, dwarves!
Okay.
I think I should have gone with Erebor.
Just go full of offensive play. Plus, you can get Gimli, and who doesn't love Gimli?
Gimli is pretty freaking overpowered.
Oh no! I'm not letting a level 3 live. Oh god, I might not actually have a. There we go, okay.
Damn it. Curse you, Rude! Well, I got one of them out of there. Oh, that's a scout hero. Not gonna win that fight.
Yeah.
Draugott sucks so bad. He died like 5 times in my Angmar overview. I do beta content on my channel as well, folks. I'm a beta tester, just FYI.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't really like him too much. He died a lot. Although my attention was stretched terribly and I was playing horribly when I did that because I knew nothing about Angmar.
Alright, I have to check. Okay, there's no outpost there.
Screw your obelisk.
They are a bit of an eyesore, I have to ground that.
I don't know, I think they look cool. They're just annoying. It's a very unique building. You don't see many obelisks in Middle-earth.
No.
I think the idea for that... Oh, hi there. I think the idea for that was, you remember in... The Fellowship of the Ring in the book, when Frodo and the other hobbits get stunned by that dark obelisk.
Yeah.
I think that's where the idea came from.
See, and that, you know what, when the beta first came out, those walls would have destroyed that mine. I'd be sipping Bacardi breezes right about now. Oh, man. But thankfully, the spiked collars give me a nice damage bonus, but not yet. So I haven't got them yet. Okay.
Well, the thing I like about Iron Hills is you don't need nothing but pikes. Because of their formation.
Yeah, a damage and armor boost.
This pike spam for days. Oh my god.
I've got filthy hillmen. I've got some orcs and I've got some wolves, so...
I bring filthy spearmen from the hills!
Exactly. A multicultural society is what Angmar is.
My guardians.
Everyone is accepted. No prejudice here.
My guardians are totally regenerating because I got one of them out of there. Alright, well, might as well get some money back. Oh, I didn't get any money back. What do you know? Mine shafts do not give money back. That's brilliant.
So it's a shame that the exile camp is bugged, because I actually really did want to fight you as Rohan, because I really wanted to see how you utilize that exile camp, because it actually seemed like such a useful building now.
Well, it's let's so just useful. Say this. If I was Rohan, you'd be stuck in your base right now.
Get the peasants!
And that's without the exile camp.
I would... I'm not going to try and argue with that. Not in the slightest.
I can't remember. Are direwolves still good against pikes?
Actually, let's have a quick look, because I remember, yeah, in vanilla, that's what they were designed. Yep, they're still good against pikes.
Well, shit, I guess I do need guardians.
So I got a little advantage there. How about some fighting? By the way, that chuckle you do, I swear, it gets me every time. I love that chuckle. That trademark chuckle.
Is that my...
It sounds like I'm laughing with you, but also I'm going to wreck you with peasants soon enough.
Anyway. That's not my full-on laugh. I've got like a really girly, high-pitched laugh when I really...
When you find something really, really funny? Yeah. Mm.
My voice goes so high, it's really embarrassing. So, how are things in Angmar Town?
Well, apparently the wolves weren't getting paid enough. There's a bit of a communist movement going on. I'm having to claw it right now.
That's not good.
No, that's not good for business. Witch King is probably going to have to enter the fray himself sooner than we thought.
Well, you're doing pretty good with your troops. I'm impressed.
Don't belittle me. Yeah, okay.
No, I'm not belittling you. I'm honestly saying I'm impressed. We shall see, though. I've got a pretty good force. I will have my point of view uploaded as well, folks, if you want to come to my channel and see it. Just give me a row of Orknets! Oh, what the hell? Oh, there it goes. What the fuck? That's a little buggy. Let's get in
there! I won't be long. Who called for some guardians? Oh man, these men of Khandoum are gonna be the death of me. Mornemoth, why aren't you free?
By the way, I wanted to let you know one thing I saw when you did your Iron Hills video. Dane's Messenger on Naren, that's a passive ability. The active effect just gives Naren speed.
Oh, okay. So the armor boost and experience is passive.
Yep.
Okay.
The active is just if you need to get the hell out of there really quick because he's almost dead.
Okay. I have to say, I love the look of these Barrowites with the runes on it. They're so beautiful.
Yep. Beautiful and overpowered. Those are the single reason why I don't like Angmar that much, because, my god.
Yeah. Wait, what
threat
the hell
health steal with every attack, and then every kill they get levels up the barrow and makes them even more overpowered.
Yeah.
Ridiculous. Alright. Let's see what we can
it's
do here.
It's a little quiet on the Western Front. That makes me very nervous.
Quiet for now, laddie.
Just wait. The horns of hell are upon you. Oh, God. Oh, no. There's a gate that has to be shut somewhere. And it rhymes with mine.
Tana! Juranu! Send
that
in the
might
gold.
Be the scariest thing ever. Okay. If that's Naren, then I'm pretty sure. Okay. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I have to retreat every single unit I have under the sun.
And that's just my first army. The other one's coming up on your barrow now.
Well played.
Come back here, Rangers. You aren't going away. I'm not going to let you escape. You cost a lot of money.
Yes, they do.
Where do you think you're going? Hey,
okay. Well, we're gonna have to get
Rangers.
We're gonna have to get some pikes, I think. And unfortunately, these men of Khandoum mean they're extremely costly.
Yeah, that's why Mornemoth is kind of important.
Oh no, I was just about to get the curse of the Barrowite on that. No, they were so beautiful. Oh, you struck just at the right time.
Well,
exactly.
That makes me happy.
I bet. Okay. I can't be mad. I love these Ram Riders. They're so beautiful.
Yeah, they are pretty fun now that they got Naren to give them leadership. I never liked them before, but I do now.
Now we just need something to...
Holy crap, they're so strong!
Oh, yeah. It's like having tower guards that run at the speed of light.
Oh, where do you think you're going, Draglin?
No, he's not fallen.
Yeah, well, he will when I give my super speed. Come back here! Come back here, you wolf bastard!
I really did not expect Ram Riders, and I don't know why. Oh, no.
Well, I was talking specifically about Naren.
They're so powerful, though, and I... Oh, man. Really gonna be difficult to repel these now. I know, because I wrecked with them earlier, and it was so much fun. Oh, man. Okay.
It's one of those things you hate to love it, but you love to hate it.
Okay, I better not do that.
Oh, man.
Okay,
so
what's
left? I was able to afford that, folks? By filling my base and upgrading it. Alright. Oh, hey, it's an orc camp.
My beautiful Barrowite's reduced to ash, and I was just about to get Curse the Barrowite, and it would have been awesome, but nah.
No Barrowites for you. Oh, hi there.
Thorin, you cannot do this.
No, Draglin, if you fall, we all fall.
I will not stand down before any elf.
Well, Draglin's not... Okay, he stood down. He stood down in the dirt.
Oh, those are pikes, aren't they? Let's see who's better.
I really don't think, especially with Naren leading the line, with his combat command, I think you might be okay. Just a little bit.
Yeah, I think you're getting your butt kicked. Holy crap.
Yeah, I really did not expect those. Oh, shit.
You have yourself to thank, because I saw how overpowered they were in your Iron Hills overview video. If it hadn't been for that, I probably would have still underestimated them.
Yeah, they are amazing.
They are
I'm
amazing.
I'm not even salty about it. They're just, I just love them.
Well, I hope you're having as good a time as me.
You know what? I am. So that's good for me. But yeah, right. I'm trying to think how I can actually kill these things now.
Well, let's get the upgrades going.
What could I make?
Man, let me tell you, Naren really wants a row of orc necks. He's like begging for it. You are not prepared for what I'm going to do to you.
If it rhymes with Demolisher,
No, it doesn't rhyme with Demolisher.
Okay, that's thankful.
It does rhyme with a certain something else that's rather prevalent on your channel, though.
Uh-oh. Okay, I'm trying to think what I could actually do to stem.
Oh, whoa. Don't you be destroying my mind. What do you think you're doing?
Well, given that it's 6 inches from my base, I felt maybe it was a bit of a threat.
With the, fine. With the you can have that
with the dwarves' affinity for, living underground and whatnot.
You can have that one. I'll let you have that one. We're done
with this one. Okay. Oh, and you even destroyed the one at the top right. Oh, man.
Well, yeah.
To quote Elite KryPtik about 2 minutes ago, boy, you're getting your butt kicked.
Hey, I wasn't referring to you. I was referring to the pikes.
I think I was, I think it's very true, though. Right. If you're going to lose, make it to Ram Riders, because I just...
It's so much fun.
But, like, even when you're in trouble, like, combat command, let's give them 30% armor and damage, why not?
Yeah, it definitely needs... all the stuff that got implemented in this patch is totally overpowered. That's all I can say about it, really.
Yeah.
Like, the Rohan Exile Camp is completely overpowered. Did you know that we did a test, me and my friend yesterday, and their new swordsmen, the Wardens, or the Soldiers of the Westfold, whatever they're called, they actually beat Tower Guards 1v1.
Oh. So... Exile Camp beats elite units.
Yeah, basically, Gondor has nothing now versus Rohan. Literally nothing.
Okay, so there's a lumber mill outside my base.
Yep, and what did lumber mills make, Rude?
Oh, you wouldn't dare. Actually, this will be interesting. I'll look forward to it.
I've got a master plan that I've been just coordinating for the past 2 days, ever since you said you were going to play with me.
Oh, my pike decided to charge. I totally didn't want them to do that. Okay.
I can kill Rudar with my cavalry.
Oh yeah, you can kill them, no problem.
Hey, you guys went too far ahead. Those are the good pikes.
I'm on my way.
I love how Naren has the Gimli quotes from War of the Ring. I'm talking about the game.
Why did I just do that? I didn't need to do that. That gave me no advantage. I didn't mean to hit that. Oh, well.
Well, you did get to see some dwarves go flying.
Oh, there's King Dane in there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's...
A fight. And there's a certain other hero about to come and join
us. The battle?
And another hero. Oh, shit. I just realized I destroyed my mine on the front lines, and now I can't teleport in there. Damn it! I've replaced it with the lumber mill.
I'm listening.
All right. Walk over there slowly. Well, you know, if you're just going to stand outside your base, then I'm just going to come and kill you.
I'm trying my best, but this is... Oh, God. Wait, those are guardians. My pikes really don't have a chance against them, do they?
Nor against the pikes that are in there.
Oh, no!
Send in the goats!
No, let's not. Let's rethink. Oh, no. Oh, shit. I can't upgrade my forge because I need builders. And for that, I need camps. And I don't have any camps. Oh, no! Alright, if we can kill Naren, then it'll be a good day. It'll be a good day. Kill him. He must fall.
Get the hell out of there, Naren.
I think he's gotten away. I think he was the one that got away.
The one that got away, isn't there a song?
Oh, man. I'm trying to think how this game would have gone if Ram Riders weren't a thing. I would like to think I would have done a lot better, but maybe that's just wishful
thinking. I don't know, man. Iron Hill's pike wall doesn't fuck around.
And this is just a foregone conclusion because there's heroes in there. Plus guardians against my beloved pikes.
Alright, Undermine. That'll let me get my heroes to the front line quicker. Thank you. Hey, Murin finally walked his ass over here.
I like Murin. He doesn't destroy RuudDevil. It's written in his ability. I think level 1 says... I'm not sure. Could be. Okay.
Right, let's get some upgrades.
I never did get enough builders to upgrade my thing, otherwise I could just... Oh, actually.
Dane's quotes are so good now.
Well, then.
Oh, hey. Siege? That's not cool, man. That's not cool. Now I'm gonna have to get siege. I wanted to do this without siege, but you had to go and bring siege.
I had to go and bring siege into the equation. Oh no.
I was just getting my beautiful upgrades. You merciless bastard.
I'm just thinking back to how quickly I lost map control, and it's so beautiful.
I hope you're not making boats to go to that island. That would be pretty underhanded.
Canceling boats? No. No, I'm not.
Oh, man. Laborers cost 30 each? That's ridiculous. That's far too much.
Given that they look like they're armored out to just go to war, I think that's a fair price.
Does Mac Pollitt know that there are, like, armored out dwarven laborers in this mod? Because I'm sure that would make him love it, like, way more.
I think I would need to tell him that.
Yeah. It seems like an important detail not to leave out when speaking to Mac.
Okay. These Khandun Bowmen are 700. And I think the only reason they're 700 is so that Mortimer's ability makes sense.
Everything you just said was Dane was saying his epic quotes at the same time. The entire elf speech of, I will not stand down before any elf. Oh, hey there.
These wolves are going on so far, just so we can actually see what we're up against. And they're going to be chased by Ram right now.
Come back here, you silly, silly wolf.
Oh, if we can get some laborers, it'll be a good day.
No, not the laborers! What have they ever done to you?
Too many
things. They're about to do something. You're not going to like laborers very much at the end of this day.
Oh, no. I think if I set a record for the first man to be defeated by laborers, I'll be pretty happy about that.
Well, that's the plan. That's why I've got lumber mills.
Let it be known, folks. That's the plan, implying that this could have been over a long time ago, let's be fair.
Well, I normally would just make rams, like the battering rams.
Right.
But, I wanted to do something a little special to celebrate you and Mac being so awesome.
What's that wolf doing? Oh, he's dead. Okay.
Alright, let's finish up raiding my boys.
Decisions.
Ah, I finally got elite equipment. Alright, banner carrier.
Oh, you need wolf breeding now to get the werewolves, and you need spike collars. Okay.
Oh my god, Dane's quotes are so good.
At least this faithless woodland sprite.
Yeah, he literally just said that as you said it.
I'm not saying me and him are one, but we're pretty damn close.
Oh, for the love of God. You got one random wolf there still attacking. Alright, give me a
go, time. Timmy, go! Win the day!
Timmy's about to get an axe to his anus.
He's biting into solid rock. I can only salute him.
God, that would be terrible for your teeth.
Yeah. That would be... Okay, I have a decision to make. I don't know how good these werewolves are. I know that they get killed very quickly to pikes.
Need the siege plans, laddie. Upgraded dwarves, though? You think they can kill them? Like, well, you raise a good point, KryPtik. Alright, Timmy the Wolf.
I'm staring at Zafragor, and I'm just praying that if I make him, he'll automatically be level 10, just through some sheer fluke.
Honestly, I think level 5 Dane could probably take him.
Okay.
Oh, I don't have any Mithril. I could totally get some veterans.
You have complete map control, so travel camp is totally possible.
Well, it's possible early game, too, if the map is one where you can hide your camp well. Alright.
Yeah, I think I remember you saying that in one of the tournament videos.
I really want to go and kill those obelisks.
While I dare say this has been somewhat easy for you, I do hope you're still enjoying it and you're not bored.
For sure, man.
Okay, that's just what I worry. I don't want you to be bored. I want you to have fun.
Do you not notice how much I was laughing for the first 5 minutes of the video?
Good point.
I'm like a kid in a candy store right now.
Oh, man.
Alright. The boring part is right now building up the forces to end the game.
Well, I think the Edain team made a mistake because they put in summon trolls, but I don't see any summon Haldir, and I don't.
Gotta be Rohan for that, and you know they made summon Haldir way stronger now.
They did actually. Mm-hmm. Oh wait, even his summon as well.
Yep.
Okay.
And by the way, Haldir does not. I'm just gonna say this for all the folks who don't play the Edain mod: Haldir doesn't suck in the Edain mod. Rude is false advertising when he says that. Haldir is quite reliable in the Edain mod. I didn't upgrade my Ramriders yet.
These werewolves can't fit through
the gates.
Okay. Yeah.
Let's have a little look-see. What you're up to. Nice base, bro.
Thanks, buddy.
Oh, wow. 3 werewolves. I think they're vulnerable against pikes, which I have plenty of.
They are. They'll die as quickly as attack trolls.
I'm just gonna poop on your soldiers here for a little while.
They're actually trembling. They're scared of bird poop. Very much so.
So much bird poop. No! Our only weakness. Alright, give me some banners to regenerate my boys here.
You said you wanted to kill an obelisk, and I'm tempted to just summon one in front of you so you could get your wish.
Well, that would be real nice of you. I don't think it's necessary, though. Because I'm about to have something that can really kill your obelisks very quickly.
Oh, it's going to be catapults.
Iron Hills, Erebor, ready to dwarf anyone?
Yep, Iron Hills, Erebor, ready to dwarf.
I don't know where you came up with that. That's pretty funny, though. Alright. Oh my god, that's the only problem with this map, it just takes so long to build up, even when you have total map control.
Where is it?
Lack of build plots.
Guard this area!
We need him! Where is he?
Day has dawned!
Oh, cool. I'll use that. Go ahead and heal up my wounded dwarves.
Damn it, those are pikes! Run away!
Oh, yeah.
Oh shit, werewolves. I was trying to... Oh, the Ram Riders have decided to enter the fray.
Oh, you bet. Oh, shit, that's siege. Back up. No, not to the King Dane. Back to the base. Back to the base. Holy crap, I have 2,000 gold. Cash floating is so bad.
Oh, you've summoned some lovely lone towers, and there's a catapult right in the back there. All right, Crash Bandicoots, I'd like to think that you will do me a favor and win this day.
Holy crap, they're doing pretty good.
Well, I think I disoriented you with the fell wind.
Well,
just to get
it doesn't help that I was looking away when you attacked because I thought you had retreated.
Oh no! So all that money gone down the drain. Crash Bandicoots, under RuudDevil, you fight to the death. There is no retreat in my book. Even when up against upgraded dwarves, are these things have heavy armor?
I think they. Well, yeah. That's not all they have, though. They also have many heroes.
There's Edain, who's got his vendetta now. And Murren, who's just going full blitzkrieg. Okay. Okay,
Edain
I got.
Just keeps screaming to the king. It's so good.
To the king!
How many catapults do you think I need? Do you think 8 is overkill?
I think I would love to see that many fireballs going.
Alright, we'll make 8 catapults. No, you fools! You could have survived! You could have lived! You could have had children! Ran forward! You died horribly!
Who is this? Your brother? That is my wife! I don't know whether I love or hate that dwarven females have beards.
What is this? Filthy orc something rather. And he's
yeah,
like, that
Goblin
is
Nugent.
My wife!
That's great.
Alright, let's get pumping out those laborers.
I've been sitting on a ton of money because I really don't know what to build. This has just been how to kill RuudDevil in the most entertaining way.
Well, I figured as we were coming into this, you know, if I am going to beat you, I might as well make it entertaining.
You know what? Secretly, like, I get bothered on Game Ranger so much. Not because, like, it's me, but because they all want to beat me. So I think everyone watching is just. They just got a huge grin on their face. They can't wait to see how I lose.
Well, if you want, I could start leaving comments to help you improve your skill, and you could get good and start wrecking some noobs.
Well, that was part of it, too. I'd like to get better.
I would tell you, like, I haven't seen your game enough, and I don't know enough about Angmar, so I can't really help you there. But when it comes to the other factions, I'm pretty good, so.
Okay.
I'm still not used to Angmar myself, and I don't really want to learn them while they're so overpowered, because I know they're just going to get nerfed into next week. I want to learn the metas when they're actually stable. Iron Hills Catapult, you take way too long to build, my friends. Alright, I think 5 is good. I'm actually not going to build 8, sorry. Alrighty. All I can hear is the laborers building materials. How many laborers is too many? Let's gather them all.
There is never too many. That's the beauty of them.
Well, I think I got about 100. Let's keep making them. Oh, also, another thing to let you know, this might help you when you're playing Mordor or a spammy faction. If you hold down shift when you click to queue up units, it will queue up 5 at a time.
Yeah. I actually learned that from a video of yours as well.
Damn, I'm glad they've been helping so much.
Not based on this performance, but you know.
Hey man, it's dwarves and ram riders, there's not much you could have done.
I love those ram riders, they're so beautiful there. And I'm zooming in right now on your dwarven army. And yeah, the rework, just the aesthetically rework, it's just so nice.
Hey, keep zooming in on it for a second, they're about to get really, really bright.
Oh no.
Make them glow.
Stonehelm.
Ironbreakers, join the fray, lads!
Meanwhile, I've got one battalion of hillmen.
Well, I want to make a full 1800 army to make it a big spectacle when I siege you, but I'm worried that the people watching might just get bored, so.
Yeah.
I guess I'll go ahead and get her going here.
Where are they? Dwarves!
Get the Ironbreakers up here.
On the double thing, I heard that.
Oh, can you hear? I'll have to.
No,
that.
Just ever so faintly. It's not a problem, but oh man. All
right. Well, they are gonna have to wait a minute because I still have to make laborers. Alright, let's queue up 20 on each lumber mill.
I love that the iron breakers get pickaxes. It's just so wonderful.
Yeah, I think the pickaxes are actually quite a bit superior to the axe and shield because of the knockback.
What is the armor debuff now on that?
What they lose is 50%.
Right, okay.
Or 40%, sorry.
Okay. Okay. I just realized that my swordsmen of Khandim have duelist, so they should do quite a bit more damage to your units.
Well, you gotta remember that my Raven debuff completely removes that.
Oh.
Just like your Raven debuff completely removes my Guardian's stubbornness. Or your Obelisk debuff, rather. Laborers! All the laborers!
Yeah, laborers! Oaths you have taken!
Now, fulfill them all for Lord and Land!
if they ever just wanted to be funny, they could have like a separate ammunition type for the catapult where it just chucks a laborer.
That's a brilliant idea.
I don't know if you ever... The cave troll, when they could throw goblins. It was just one-hit signal fires and things like that.
Yeah, freaking, oh man, somebody who knows how to code, please make a sub-mod for the Edain mod that's just labor ammunition for everything they can throw boulders. Ents, trolls, catapults.
Oh, man.
So can you see how many laborers I have right now?
No. I can just see, like, your main army.
Well, I can't bring them up to show you because your catapults will shoot me in the face.
I'm okay to make that trade. I don't know about you.
I'm not. These guys take a while to build.
Why? I hope everyone's enjoying this.
Oh, man.
Holy
I
shit, there's the motherload.
I hope people will come to see my, holy crap, that troll catapult's got some range. Jesus Christ! How much damage does it do? Alright.
Draglin, you have the aggro of...
Alright, let's go draw that catapult's fire because it's freaking overpowered as shit. That is ridiculous that it does that much damage. Holy crap. Yeah, that's right. I said it. It's ridiculous. Alright. Sorry, I got a little upset.
Oh no. Defend, dwarves! Actually, maybe I could shift your fire.
No, don't do that. Don't do that.
Select the catapult, you buck.
How freaking strong are these walls anyways? I am gonna need like 8 catapults.
I guess can't- oh god. Draglin, I think if you die this time, I think that might be it for you. Okay, that's it for you,
Draglin. I told you, he dies a lot. He's so easy to kill.
I was just waiting to do his level 10 ability, but...
Alright, well, those catapults are way too strong, man.
Oh no! I was too late. Ah, Snowblind, shit.
Well, Snowblind wouldn't have protected the catapult, it just protects the catapult building.
Oh, okay. Fair enough.
Alright, well, I'm gonna have to get a second siege works and make, like, 10 catapults. This is gonna take a while. Rude, your defense is stubborn. You would make the dwarves proud.
Oh, man.
Holy crap, my dwarves are so screwed up. Heal up, folks. These laborers are so epic right now. They are lagging my game horrendously.
I've switched my game to medium settings and it actually runs a lot smoother now.
Yeah, I've got them on like sort of upper medium.
I think I put the shader down. I think that might apparently that's what was doing it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, now I gotta rebuild my siege, so
we're gonna be here a while.
Well, it's your own damn fault. You're being stubborn.
When your favorite race is the dwarves.
just for the folks at home, don't get mad at me. This is not me, it's him.
Okay. I'm seeing your level 4 ram riders. I think you're fine.
Level 4? Damn. I didn't even realize that. Oh, man.
Oh, hold on. Oh, no, I did get that. Okay. We are the kings, man.
It's too bad you can't use Thorin's runes on the Ram Riders.
Yeah. Right.
I didn't even know you knew what they did. The only time I ever saw you look at them, you said you weren't going to look at them because you didn't understand them.
I remember I actually did take the time to learn them, but I'd never really bother with them usually.
Oh man, they are so good, especially if you put them on veterans. Well, let me just read off the effects to you here. First one that you get is 25% resistance against fire, ice, poison, and magic. So as you can imagine, that's pretty pretty helpful.
That's pretty damn useful.
And then the second one is resources for every killed enemy.
Third that's one is incredibly useful.
25% more experience. And the level 8 one is 25% more damage in general to enemies. Plus, you know, that's all on top of Forge Blade and everything.
It's funny, because when you'll watch this from my perspective, it's just going to be a picture of my base, just constantly. just constantly.
Well, that's pretty much what it is for me, too. It's a picture of my base and a few of the different buildings. All right, let's grab that. That might help a little bit. With breaking this damn Angmar defense. Let's see if they're ready for this. I don't know if I have enough laborers. I don't think I do. I think I've got like 200 laborers. Doesn't seem like enough.
Push, dwarves, push!
Alright, 5 catapults, so we need 5 more.
So, you never played 3.8. How did you originally find out about it, Edain?
Your channel.
Oh, okay, cool. That's funny. I don't know why that makes you laugh. Let's just.
I watched your 3.8 videos and I was like, "Oh, that's pretty cool." And so I started following the Edain mod, but I didn't want to play it because it wasn't translated properly.
Right.
And as soon as 4.0 came out, I immediately got it, and I started working on translating the English, and that's how I got to be a beta tester. Pretty much every text you see in the game has been looked over by me.
Okay, so me being able to understand what's going on, I owe to you.
Well.
Possibly,
and obviously FG for redoing it. That's the guy on the team who does the text work. I send in the translations and he implements them.
Okay. Oh man, I really wish Angmar had that ice munition upgrade. Like, Gondor gets a fire munition upgrade from their stoneworker. That'd be so useful right about now.
Listen, your catapults are OP enough as it is. They were able to two-shot my catapults without the upgrade. That's ridiculous. I don't think any other wall catapult in the game can do that. That's insane. Alright, 8 catapults.
Originally we thought that was overdoing it, but...
Well, now it's probably just going to barely be enough. You got so many on the wall there. I do have a certain other something that might help a little bit as well. Rhymes with IT... Batabolt. I'm not very good at it.
That's great. That'll actually seal it for you.
We'll see. I don't know how much damage it does to structures. It's more of an army killer, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 catapults. 8, 9. You'd be surprised how little money I'm making, actually.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised it's taken so long.
Well, there's how many settlements on this map? And I'm not using the laborers, so I've really only got 1, 2, and then counting the Arid Mithrin outposts, so 3 outer settlements and my base.
Oh.
Because I'm not using the laborers to chop down trees. I've just got them kind of hanging out. Iron Hills catapult ready for war. Okay, making my final catapult now. It's because the build time is so slow on the Forge Works.
Oh, well, we've gone and hit our command point limit. Well, what's that about?
Shit, what are you doing hitting your command point limit?
I don't know. Scrubby McScrubby. I think because I was doing so badly on resources, I didn't go for a pantry upgrade on some of these.
Oh, okay, I thought you meant 1800. All right, that's good then.
No. I'm at 800. Which is, needless to say, a little short of the mark.
Ready?
Alright, let's upgrade my dwarves just to make sure I got as many of them as I can.
Remember to go over your army, don't rush or anything. You want to make sure you don't want your catapults to die like last time. That was a little embarrassing.
Well, last time I didn't know I thought there was only one catapult on the wall, and I didn't scout with ravens first. Alright, heavy armor. And forge blades. Come on. So, how are things in Angmar Town now?
Well, We dealt with that communism, and now Bolshevism has just risen, even though that's essentially the same thing. So, I don't know. I really don't know. The politics of Angmar is complex.
Fair enough. Straight from the Iron Hills. Okay. I would actually assume that Angmar is probably more of a socialist dictatorship.
More of a despotism thing.
Yeah. All right, 10 Iron Hills catapults. Surely
that's,
to God.
That's the spirit. Come on, all right.
Surely to God.
So is the goal here to just knock out the defenses and then send in the laborers for the coup de grace, so to speak?
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay.
I'm planning on killing your citadel with my laborers. Because we all know, laborers, as awesome as they aren't really very good at the whole fighting thing.
Nah.
Awaiting your orders.
Units await my orders.
I think that's a Total War quote.
That is one of my favorites.
It's interesting because Dak takes a bunch of quotes from Edain, and Edain takes a bunch of quotes from Dak. They trade quotes.
Right.
Dak is Divide and Conquer. You were playing with Moss, which is the other big submod. All right, I'm going to go ahead and get another 80 laborers. Or 60 laborers. Oh, wow, I actually don't have enough money. All right. Move up the catapults.
What's going on here? Oh, some lovely ravens that I can't shoot out the sky.
Take out that damn obelisk. It's an eyesore. What do we need built? Let's get to the building. What do we need materials? Oh my God, the range on those things.
No, the obelisk. Oh, well, you know what? We'll just do that.
Take your obelisk and shove it.
Oh my sweet Mary. Fire quickly. There you go. I'm not even mad. That's amazing.
Oh crap, two catapults have fallen. Oh, three catapults have fallen. Take that thing down.
Bring it down, says Theoden.
Oh, you poor archers. Bring that down.
I would be using Snowblind, but it doesn't protect the catapult, just the stand.
Yep. Alright, lads. We're finally
through. Oh my goodness, that was a triple. You're not joking when you say these things. They're a little...
Oh no, I wasn't. They are completely
open. Oh, my archers!
Take your archers and shove them.
Is there anything I have that you would like me not to shove? I'm perfectly flexible.
I don't know.
The gate has been breached!
Right, let's get this done. Send in the goats!
There's combat, come on, they're not gonna die anytime soon.
Oh, I don't think my mighty catapult can reach.
Did they finally nerf the global range?
Oh, no, it fired. Where is it?
Oh, there's some people floating above my thing, okay.
Stand between me and my kin! I'll split his pretty head open!
There's no kin here, I assure you.
Oh, there was the mighty catapult. Got there far too late.
Alright, so this well-looking two-hit a catapult.
Oh shit, I didn't even notice that. That's not nice. What do my catapults ever do to you? Oh wow, they die easily. Those werewolves are terrible. Charge of the Iron Hills, laddie!
There's definitely going to have to be some reworks. Where are these laborers? I don't see any laborers. Or are they in there?
Oh, they're coming. Don't worry. I had to deal
with
my
men of Khandoom are holding as well as they can, but that's just too much.
You see that charge of the Iron Hills? That was glorious.
Good old Mirren.
Alright, let's get a Jurin's Day. Fountain Stand probably would have been a better choice, but I want to get Earthquake if I can. Holy crap, it's laggy.
What would you have said was the better choice?
Are you talking about the PowerPoints?
Yeah, you said Durin's Day, and you said something would have been better.
I said that Final Stand would have been more suitable for me in this situation, because it gets quadruple armor, but I want to get Earthquake if I can.
Alright, let's see if I can take out the last of those catapults. Probably not.
Oh, who the heck is that? That's just some orcs. Well, here comes the laborers. It's the last march of the laborers.
I figured you would have punched straight through to the citadel.
Well, I was dealing with your troop production first. The laborers are coming now.
Okay, I didn't really bother to build anything because they would just die. It would just be delaying the inevitable.
What the hell? You got another catapult?
I rebuilt.
Oh, you cheeky bastard.
Fire it, no! Come
bring
on!
Bring it down! Bring it down!
Go, fire, fire! Oh, I wasn't fast enough.
Holy crap, I told you guys to retreat.
That is a lot of laborers, and they even brought their lumber mills.
Oh, of course. You gotta
bring
lumber.
Okay. Well, here's a summon to annihilate all that hard work of yours.
Oh, shit.
When they get there, and not push past my lines. But you had level 5 goat riders. And okay.
Damn orcs from Mount Graham. Leave my laborers alone.
What can we call this mountain? Mount Graham. Seems good to me. Alright, just to frustrate you a little bit. There we go. So now they just have to stare at it.
Oh, I didn't even realize my dwarves were attacking. I keep telling them to retreat and they're not listening to me because it's so laggy. Oh, that's okay. We'll just kill some buildings in the back here while we wait. Little warm-up to the citadel.
Is it?
Oh, I can't even hit them. They're invulnerable.
Is it a terrible thing that I've colonized the bottom island?
Oh, did you?
Well,
I honestly kind of expected it.
I was like, well, do I want Zafragorn, Witch King, to die? No. So let's just
go, my laborers. Hit that citadel with your beautiful logs of wood. And I swear that wasn't a euphemism. Let's see how long it takes.
Well, they're dressed for the part, but damage-wise, it doesn't seem. Okay.
Oh, you're probably never going to want to play with me again. I'm killing you with laborers. I feel so bad.
I'm preferring the out of sight, out of mind tactic, and that's I'm making a new colony for myself. We will call this New Angmar.
Your orcs can't be trampled. That's weird. I wonder if Horn of the Dwarves affects the laborers. Oh, it totally does.
Really? Oh man.
All right. I just want to destroy this stupid citadel, and then I will send my army in to finish off the rest of this.
Oh, he wasn't in his wolf form yet. That's still called the pack, rather than the knives. That was weird.
So I've got 8,000 resource cash flow right now.
I will protect my base. Struggling, kill those laborers.
Oh,
killing me with laborers. That's a good day. It's been a good day.
Is Struggling losing to laborers?
No, thankfully not.
All right. Well, let's Naren in there, and cease fire on Draglin.
I think I already used my leap.
No, I'm sorry, you're not allowed to attack. I did not give you permission to attack. No attack for you.
Curse you and your ceasefire. This is not the 38th parallel. All right. All right, let's go back in. I don't know if it's the ceasefire or the pathfinding. It might be the ceasefire that's preventing Draglin from moving.
It might be the pathfinding, though.
Yeah, he's trapped in my laborers, is what I'm trying to say. Okay.
I've got Naren helping a little bit. Heal up the laborers, laddie!
No, the ceasefire must still be in effect.
Alright, let's kill him.
No, Naren! Do it! No!
Yes! The citadel has fallen. Now send
I have
in the
a level. All right, I have a level 5 Witch King and a level 5 Zafragor on a boat back to the mainland. And when they fall, I'll happily destroy what I built on the island, just so you don't have to build a navy and come after me.
Well, that would be nice of you. Save a little time. Actually, and that's really just nice for the viewers. They don't have to watch me build a fleet. I've never really looked at the dwarven fleet before. I've seen the Rohirrim fleet. Everybody's got custom boats.
There's plenty of work to go around.
Oh, man.
We're done with this one.
Well, I suppose now that somebody's been killed by laborers, it's not funny anymore.
Oh, man.
I took it too far, didn't I?
I give you an A for your style. Okay.
I just realized
I only made one transport ship, so it seems that... I guess I could make another one, but honestly, I can't be bothered.
Well, each transport ship can transport two heroes.
Yeah. And I've made five, but... So only two are coming.
All right.
Okay, here we go. I had fun.
I had a lot of fun. I just hope that actually utilizing laborers wasn't taking it too far. I think I might have...
No, it's fine. Don't worry about it.
I think I might have ruined the joke a bit.
I think as soon as I put in the description, I lose to laborers, people will hang around waiting and waiting and waiting. It is the ultimate clickbait,
Clickbait is when you put something in the title that implies something happens but doesn't actually happen.
Yeah.
So it actually happens.
Oh my goodness, Might of the Witch King, go in on Zafragar.
To the king! Formations!
Oh god, Witch King, what are you doing? Now is not the time.
Stubbornness! Horn of the Dwarves!
I don't know how much the explosions Ravens. Are doing, but it is on the beaches of Falundin, the Witch King, that his fate.
Oh, hang on. Let's use Righteous Strike on Zafagor, see how much damage it does. Go for it, man! Well, and we will
be the heroes. Zafagor's got about... Oh my god. Zafagor! I mean, Arthas! Don't die! Oh boy, okay.
Warcry! Baruk Kazad!
Oh, bollocks. I just realized I can't just demolish my own outpost.
Hey, look at that! The buffs are totally working underneath the debuff. You see that?
Mm-hmm. Well, from what little vision I do have.
Alright.
Okay. I can't destroy my own thing, I don't think, so I think I'll just have to exit the game.
Oh, hold on. I'll get a win. I'll build some transport ships. They build pretty quick. I'll just send over my heroes. 1, 2, 3, 4 heroes. So I need 2 transport ships. Do I have any summons I could put there? I got enough for Earthquake. I wonder how long it would take Bayorn to kill your citadel. I can't get vision over there. Raven's got leadership. That's funny. Alright, 2 transport ships. I don't ever like just having to leave the game. I like it. Might as well get the proper win, I figure. After playing
fair enough,
the entire
fair
game.
Enough.
Alright. You two on that transport ship. And you two on that transport ship. I feel like you're gonna be sneaky, and I'm gonna get there, and there's gonna be like way more waiting for me.
Oh no! If that was the case, I wouldn't have sent over my 2 highest leveled heroes.
Well, you also said that you've got a bunch more heroes.
Yeah, I've got 3 standing here, just outside the outpost, just awaiting their doom.
Okay, so
you've got one final battle.
One final battle to end off the might of the laborers. Transport ships are pretty quick. We're here already.
On the plus side, I have stone and iron to build for Angmar.
Oh my god, you just couldn't let... You had to say it, didn't you? We're almost at the end of the episode. We're almost at the end of the episode, and... damn it, Rude. Weapons, dwarves! Weapons! Hey there, fellas.
The Ram Riders and Naren. I wonder how someone is supposed to combat that. Oh, jeez.
Alright, let's cease fire that one. Oh no! Naren! Lag! Killed him!
So wait, I killed Naren?
Yeah, you killed Naren.
Oh shit. Oh god, now Dane's into the fray.
I did manage to get ceasefire off on Mournemouth, though. Yeah, I knew you were gonna do that. All right, let's give these bastards a good hammering.
Tanna.
Oh yeah, Bayarn can't heal anymore. Brilliant.
Yeah, he can't. He gets sensed by a fear or something. Onomoth's fallen. Murren is about to die.
I didn't get charge of the dwarves off. Damn you, Rude. We got this. Are there any more heroes? Did I kill them all?
I think you might have killed them all. But I'm sending in a builder who can't even throw water.
Bjorn just walked into a tree and knocked it over. My axe tower is
if this Dane gets level 10... What level is your Dane? I can't...
Level 9?
Okay. Oh, he's on the cusp of it. He could summon in...
Come on!
Stonehelm was there too.
Oh my god. I need like a little tiny bit more experience.
This has been a strange game.
The king is not here. We can't go to the king right now.
There is no Thorin on the battlefield.
He's
Let's make
it. In the Arid Luwin faction, Dane.
There it is. I like how you can actually summon the... Yep, there they are. The unburnt right there.
Well, isn't it random each time?
It is, but I like that you can summon the heavy infantry.
I have 20,000 gold.
Alright, Dane. Bring your pretty face to my sword.
Okay. Ow! Holy shit!
Go, go! Yes! Very nice.
No!
I don't know how the Might of the Witch King buff is still in effect. That's a little strange.
Come back here! Bring your ugly face to my axe!
How have they not caught up with me? Those are Arid Luwin? Alright, fuck
it. Well, Arid Luwin only get bonuses and if fight. There's three or more. Many
brave warriors oh, that's right.
Alright, well, the only one left standing now is Thorin Stonehelm. But fortunately for me, and unfortunately for you, I got Undermine.
No. There's really nothing I can do against that. Unless I make some sneaky battle towers.
Oh man, if I brought over the laborers.
Oh my goodness, you could actually.
They're a single unit that would take way too long. I would have to deal with them five at a time, and I've got like 200 there. Let's get in there! Alright, can Ram Riders? They can. We go. Positions. Enter. Get in the damn mineshaft, you lazy pricks. Grab your weapons. We'll stay in there. Get in there! Thorin, heal him! He's still standing. Pull back. All right, the Ram Riders are here.
I thought I did well killing all these heroes.
Yeah, you did. Oh, no. Last little bit of annoyance before I finish you off.
The hell, Stonehelm? There he goes. He's gone down.
He's got.
This is what I call one hell of a last stand. But the Ram Riders, the bane of my existence, have finally come in. Alright, well, the only hero I can afford now is Hawaldo. Level 1, I'm not sure if he's gonna do much.
I'm doubtful.
I'm gonna use a plague on nothing.
Oh, yes. No! Come on, hurry up, PowerPoints, come on.
Is it gonna be Earthquake?
I don't think so, I'm not getting any. You're. Outpost is kicking my ass! That garrison tower, man.
Even the outpost at Angmar's is stupidly powerful. Oh, man.
Alright, well, we're gonna have to start sending in the laborers. Nah, I'm just kidding.
Why is that? Well, we've sent everything else. Okay.
That's all we got left, I'm afraid, is the citizens of our nation. No more warriors. Yeah. They've all been killed. Quick, make some Molotov cocktails, boys. Come on, I'm so close. I need a quarter of a PowerPoint.
Well, Droglin's about to come out, so you kill him again, I think you'll get your PowerPoint.
Your audio
in about 5 seconds, he might be able to beat the outpost.
Oh, come on, it's a sliver. Got it.
No.
Boom!
There it is. Oh, fate of black. Very nice. I enjoyed myself. I think we drew that out a little too long.
Ah, well.
But aside from that, it was a fun game.
Well, I mean, what you can do is you can just put in that the game was basically over when the laborers killed you, if you want, and then people who want to stop watching there can.
Alright, so that was me versus Elite KryPtik. I hope you guys all enjoyed. I'll be putting a link to his video, to his channel in the description, so you can check out more of his lovely stuff there. KryPtik, you can say goodbye to the boys and girls.
Alright, well, thanks again for watching, everybody, and until the next video, stay awesome.